Hello everyone, welcome to lecture on VHDL module for comparator and 4-bit full add. At the end of this session, students will be able to analyze, design and implement comparator and 4-bit adders. Now before starting with the actual session, let's pause the video and think about what is meant by components. Right? So it is nothing but the simply a conventional code in that which is nothing but your VHDL module, but which contains the library or package declaration plus entity and plus architecture. It can be declared in a architecture or package or in a block statement. And declaration as a component is allowed reusability of your code. Means what happens when you are using you are designing a module which requires other module. So that other module can be used as a component in your module, right? Now let's start with the 2-bit comparator, right? So this figure 1 shows the 2-bit comparator, which is having two inputs, each one is of 2-bit, right? And comparator, depending on this comparison, whether it is equal, whether it is greater than, whether it is less than, it has three outputs. So this truth table shows that according which input, what will be the output. If A equals to B, Y of 0 is 1. If A greater than B, Y of 1 is 1. And if A less than B, Y of 2 is 1. Right? So if you consider this Y is 3-bit output. Right? So now we know the inputs and outputs of our system. We know the internal working, how it is going to work. Now let's go for the VHDL module of that, right? So this is the VHDL module created using the Xilinx. This one is divided into three main parts. First part is a library declaration part, second part is a entity declaration, and the third part is a architecture declaration. Library declaration, in which you are using which library, you have to mention that. So here we are using IEEE library. So library IEEE, from that which package we are using, so that's use IEEE.stdlogic116 for this package is included. From that we are using all, so that's why that dot all is there, right? Second part, as I said, entity declaration. So entity comparator, entity name is, then we have to write the port declaration. In that we have to mention what are the inputs and what are the outputs. Now the inputs are A and B. Both are 2 bits, so that's why it is a bit vector 1 down to 0, or you can write 0 to 1. Output is again Y. Y is the output. Again, it is of 3 bit Y0, Y1, and Y2. So that's why it is again bit vector 2 down to 0. Then entity int. Now the third part is the architecture part. So architecture name of the entity name, same name supposed to be used, is architecture begin. You have to write the begin keyword. Now we know the truth table. From that truth table, we are just writing over here Y equals to 001 when A equals to B, following the truth table, else 010 when A greater than B, else 100 when A less than B. So 001 over here means Y of 0 bit is 1. Here Y of 1 bit is 1. And here Y of 2 bit is 1, right? Depending on this condition, right? Once you done with that declaration part, concurrent statement, all the concurrent statements in your architecture, you have to end the architecture. So end architecture, that is the architecture name, right? Once you done with the VHDL module, you can verify that with the help of simulation. So I use the inbuilt simulation of the Xilinx, which I used to create the VHDL model. So these are the simulation outputs. So here you can see that 2-bit signals A and B. So if you consider this condition, both are 0-0. Here A is 0-0, B is also 0-0. Right? In that case, both are equal means output is 0-0-1. Now in this condition, situation at the time, I change the value of 0-0 of A bit is 00 to 01 and keep the value 00 of B bit. In that case, it is 010. Now here I gave a similar to 0, 1 only. I change the value of b now 1, 1. B is greater, so it is having 1, 0, 0. So I verified all the three cases of 2-bit comparator. So according this, using the simulation, you can verify the working of your VHDL module. So now let's go for the 4-bit full adder. Now this is the 4-bit full adder. Now if you observe the diagram, this 4-bit complete 4-bit full adder is implemented or created with the help of 4 full adders, 1-bit full adders. So this, if you consider, this is a single bit full adder. Again, this one is single bit full adder. Again, this one is single bit full adder. So 4 single bit full adders are used. And if you consider this complete box as a one design, you can say that this is a 4-bit full adder. So means what? You can implement 4-bit full adder with the help of 4 1-bit full adders. So you're going to use, or we can going to use 1-bit full adder as a component to design a 4-bit full adder, right? These are the inputs, these are the outputs, Cin also input, and Cout is the output. Now if you consider these three, C1, C2 and C3, these are the internal signals which cannot be accessed by the user. So we have to consider these also. Okay, so now let's go for the VHDL module writing, right? So first part, obviously library declaration part, right? Then we have to write the entity, so entity name, right? In that you have to write the port declaration. In that port, we have to mention what are the inputs and outputs. So A and B, we just saw in a previous slide, A and B are the inputs, which is of type vector, so bit vector, 3 down to 0, 4 bit full adder we are designing, so 3 down to 0. Cin also input, we just saw. Then S is output, which is a type of vector, again 3 down to 0. And Cout, these are the outputs we just declared over here, which are having a interaction with the physical outside the world. But we are not mentioned over here about the C of 2, C of 1 and C of 3. Why? Because those are not accessible by user, or which is not having access to the user. So those signals supposed to be considered while writing the architecture, right? So now let's go for the architecture. See, architecture name of entity name is, now as I said, we are designing 4-bit full adder using 4 1-bit full adder. So we are using 1-bit full adder as a component. So in previous video sessions, we already studied about the 1-bit full adder. The same full adder we have to write before writing this code, and that full adder is used as a component. So component full adder name, component name, this one, this name supposed to be same as you used for the entity while creating the code for the full adder, right? And same port declaration supposed to be there. After that, end component. Now here you can see we used one temporary signal. So all these component declaration and signal declaration part is done before the begin of your architecture. Once you're done with that, architecture begin. Now here, Cin is assigned to the temp of 0, right? Then these are the component instantiation. We are using full adder as a component. So we using 4 full adder, 1-bit full adder. So we required 4 component instantiation. So FA0 full adder, that is component name. Then port map, this is a syntax for component instantiation. Now in the port map, we have to write the signals which are going to be mapped with these signals of the component. So A of 0 is mapped with the A, B of 0 is mapped with the B, temp of 0 is mapped with the Cin, and S of 0 is mapped with the S, and temp of 1 is mapped with the C, right? Similarly, second component instantiation, FA1, you have to relate this with the diagram, full adder, port map, then signals associated with the FA1. Now here A of 1, B of 1, Now the whatever the output carry generated from the previous component instantiation is as a input, right, to the second component instantiation. Then it generates two output, S(1) and temp(2). Same for the third component instantiation and the fourth one. Once you get over here, final output S(3) and temp(4). That temp(4) is nothing but your final Cout. So that going to be updated over here. Cout equals to temp(4). Then end architecture. Once you're done with the VHDL module, you can verify this with the help of simulation. This is the simulation output. You can verify that, right? So here, if you see last case, the Cout is 1 because the both last bit 1 1 is there. So because that carry will be generated, so that carry is nothing but the Cout, and this is the final sum, right? These are the references. Thank you.